Hello, everybody. I got lucky at my feet here. But I saw one of my tomato plants that something is eating, and I think it's those grasshoppers, because I haven't seen really any worms on my plants. It's all been grasshoppers. They're eating the daylights out of my plants. So I'm going to mix up my pepper spray, and I think I'm going to try spraying the tomato plant with it to see if that will help. This is a 2-gallon container right here, sprayer. And here's my pepper spray that I made, you know. I boiled a bunch of pepper flakes and jalapeno peppers. And I'm going to add about a tablespoon or teaspoon of palm olive dish soap to it. And I've had it out here in the rain, so container got pretty dirty. And I'm not putting it full strength. I'm going to put about a cup or 2 cups in my sprayer. And I'm going to try that. But one of my tomato plants is right here that something's been eating on it. And my brassica too, so I'm going to start with that one. Something's been eating on that pepper plant, and usually they don't eat on a pepper plant. This is the one I'm going to show you. Let me get the camera around here and carry the sprayer at the same time. But see that plant, that tomato plant? I've sprinkled it with 7-Dust, but I'm also going to sprinkle it with just a little bit of this pepper spray. But if you'll enlarge your, oh, hold on. Lucky, leave my tripod alone. See if I can get it turned this way, and I'll give you a close-up of it. But see how it's nothing but the stem and the limbs? They've eaten every bit of the leaves off of it except a couple right there at the bottom. So I dusted it good. And now I'm getting ready to spray it. And I'm not going to spray it so much that it washes all of the the grasshoppers. I've never seen them the way they are today. I've never had grasshoppers here like that before that try to eat up everything. I haven't seen them do it over here. But like I said, I've sprayed down a lot of stuff with, or dusted it with 7-Dust. Like my tree collard right there. I come out here this morning early and sprinkled it down with 7-Dust. So I'm hoping that's going to take care of it. And I noticed it ran the grasshoppers off of one of my tree collards under the shade cloth. They haven't bothered it since I put seven dust. So the grasshoppers don't like seven dust either. So you might think of that whenever you're walking around your garden and you see something that's eating your plants up. Grasshoppers don't like seven dust either. Now, I don't know if the pepper spray will keep them off of stuff or not. But, I see a tomato. It's turning ripe, too. See that? And I got a couple more green ones on some of these over here. But I'm going to start using my pepper spray now and see how that works. I sprayed that one tomato plant over there because it's in the shade a lot of the days. So I don't think it'll get hot enough today that it'll bother it with the pepper spray on it. And I think I'm going to have to get my Lucky, leave the tripod alone. He's rubbing up against the legs of the tripod. I think I'm going to have to take my lights off of my canopy. So if the wind pulls it over, I'll have my lights off of it already. And then I can string them back up when I put up another post or something. But that's basically the one I wanted to spray today. Because I've already got the seven dust on the other ones. I'm going to put this in here. And I'm going to have to work on another tote for some sweet potatoes, I guess. Got four more in there. Whew. Now the next time I water plants, I'm going to put Epsom salts to them, just maybe a spoonful to each plant. It doesn't take much, but Epsom salts helps a lot. And that one, container of fish emulsion is all I'm going to buy for this year, because I don't put it on there every time I use, I water, you know, put compost on them, but I do put the fish emulsion in there. I try to put Epsom salts in there too, so when the next time I water with my compost tea, I will put Epsom salts in my containers. I'm going to take my tripod over here because I think I'm going to try to take my lights down. But I think I got them up with tie wraps, so I'm going to have to go around and cut some of the tie wraps off. So I'll be right back. I got to get the ladder and a knife. The wind is blowing a little bit today. You can see how it's blowing the shade cloth. So I'm going to get up there and start taking lights down. I've got to redo this canopy frame, but I can't do it without, you know, the lights and everything on it. Whew.
got to get the more, some more, four more of the 6 foot rebars and four more of the 1x2 12 foot posts or 8 foot posts.
I
Thank you.
up. Tell me I got it wrong. I start using the strap, I guess it don't blow off my head. Wires and stuff in one location. Tomatoes have nowhere to go. They've run off the top of the... poles that I got them staked on. So they can't... there's nowhere else for them to go up there. Thank you.
morning. It's starting to get a little warm out here. That's one string down. I can get another string. Can't tell what I'm showing you. Start on the back side and take those down, and then maybe I can get these off of this post. got all of the lights down now. I gotta find a box or something to put those lights in. It's getting hot out here. Keep all this wire because I may need it. Well, y'all, as long as I stay under the shade cloth, it's pretty reasonably cool, but once I get out from under it, it gets pretty hot. And I haven't really decided how I'm going to get this down without destroying my plants. I could possibly... Get my other pieces of rebar and my other post, and what I'll do is take the shade cloth loose from this canopy and attach it at each corner when I put the new post in. That's all I know to do, and then I can somehow slip the frame out from under it. Whew. I'm gonna have to get probably, well, I know four pieces of rebar for the corner post, and then I'm probably gonna need a piece of rebar for the center post to keep that upright. So I can't take any more of it down until I get the 4 1x2s and 5 pieces of rebar. And then at least I can fix corner structures and the center structure to hold the shade cloth up. And take this metal frame out. It looks like it's about to fall anyway, I mean. And I don't know if I should go ahead and take it loose from this metal frame and just let it flap or do what it wants to do or what. Not too bad as long as you stay under the shade cloth. The
try to work, but once you get out, it gets pretty warm. Whew. And I know unless I get a piece to go across, like that cordage, you know, to go across, it's going to sag way down too much. But I may be able to get enough cord to go at least at each end to hold it up. But anyway, I got to run to the store, but I got to clean up, rest up a bit first. And then I'll have to go to the store and get the 2x2s, the pieces of rebar I need, and then come back and see what I can do with it. I don't know, first of all, how I'm going to cut these metal pieces that are already down in the concrete, because I think the rebar will go down inside it once I can get it cut off. And the wood will give a little bit. The rebar will give a little bit. So I'm hoping once I get that done that I won't have the problem with anything bending or blowing over. Because the poor frame is really bent up bad. There's no way I can fix it. So it's got to come out. And I don't think I've got a saw that will cut through metal. So I might have to look at getting me a saw, too, that'll cut through metal. So, well, I guess that's all for right now, y'all. I've got to go put these lights up, put the ladder up, go inside, take me a good hot shower or cool shower, cool off. And then see about getting the 1x2s and the rebar. And maybe the cordage to go across each end. And then I may have to wait till tomorrow to start on it. Wait till in the morning when it's cooler. So anyway, I'm going to wrap this up for right now. I might get back with you later on. See you later.